Good morning. I'm continuing my reading again from the book of Kings, the second book of Kings from the Old Testament of the Holy Bible, chapter 21 onwards. The second book of Kings, as you all know, or some of you might know, has 25 chapters. So we are reaching almost the end of the book from the Holy Bible, chapter 21. Manasseh was 12 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 55 years in Jerusalem, and his mother's name was Hephzibah. And he did that was evil in the sight of the Lord after the abominations of the heathen, whom the Lord cast out before the children of Israel. For he built up again the high places of Hezekiah his father had destroyed, and he reared up the altars of Baal, and made a grove, as did Ahab the king of Israel, and worshipped all the host of heaven and served them. And he built altars in the house of the Lord, of which the Lord had said, In Jerusalem will I put my name. And he built altars for all the host of heaven in the two courts of the house of the Lord. And he made his sons pass through fire, and observed times, used enchantments, dealt with familiar wizards and spirits. And he wrought much wickedness in the sight of the Lord to provoke him to anger. And he set a graven image in the grove that he made in the house of which the Lord said to David and to Solomon his son, In this house and in Jerusalem which I have chosen out of all the tribes of Israel, I will put my name forever. Neither will I make the feet of Israel move any more out of the land which I gave to their fathers, only if they will observe to do according to all that I have commanded them, and according to all the law that my servant Moses commanded them. And they hearkened not, and Manasseh seduced them to do more evil than did the nation whom the Lord destroyed before the children of Israel. And the Lord spake by his servants the prophets, saying, Because Manasseh the king of Judah hath done these abominations, and has done wickedly above all the Amorites did, which were before him, and had made Judah also sin with his idols. Therefore thus says the Lord God of Israel, Behold, I am bringing such evil upon Jerusalem and Judah, that whosoever heareth of it, both his ears shall tingle. And I will stretch over Jerusalem the line of Samaria, and the plummet of the house of Ahab, and I will wipe Jerusalem as a man wipeth a dish, wiping it and turning it upside down. And I will forsake the remnant of my inheritance, and deliver them into the hand of the enemies, and they shall become a prey and a spoil to all their enemies, because they have done that which was evil in my sight, and they provoked me to anger since the day your fathers came forth out of Egypt, even unto this day. Moreover, Manasseh shed innocent blood very much, till he filled Jerusalem from one end to the other. Another, because beside his sin wherewith he made Judah to sin in doing that which was evil in the sight of the Lord. The rest of the acts of Manasseh and all that he did, and his sin that he sinned, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the king of Judah? And Manasseh slept with his fathers, and was buried in the garden of his own house, in the garden of Uzzah. And Amon his son reigned instead. Amon was 22 years old when he began to reign. He reigned 22 years in Jerusalem. And his mother's name was Meshulemeth, the son of Harus, the daughter of Harus of Jotbah. And he did that was evil in the sight of the Lord, as his father Manasseh did. And he walked in all the way that his father walked in, and served the idols that his father served, and worshipped them. And he forsook the Lord God of his fathers, and walked not in the way of the Lord. And the servants of Ammon conspired against him, and slew the king in his own house. And the people of the land slew all of them that had conspired against King Ammon. And the people of the land made Josiah his son king in his stead. Now the acts of Ammon which he did, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the king of Judah? And he buried in the sepulchre of the garden of Uzzah, and Josiah his son reigned in his stead. Josiah was the son. Josiah was 8 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 31 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Jedidah, the daughter of Adaiah of Boscath. And he did that was right in the sight of the Lord, and walked in all the way of David his father, and turned not aside to the right hand or to the left. And it came to pass in the 18th year of King Josiah, that the king sent Shaphan, the son of Asaliah, the son of Meshulam, the scribe, to the house of the Lord, saying, Go up to Hilkiah the priest, that he may sum the silver which is brought into the house of the Lord, which the keepers of the door have gathered of the people, and let them deliver into the hand of the doers of the work that have the oversight of the house of the Lord. Let them give it to the doers of the work which is in the house of the Lord, to repair the breaches of the house, unto carpenters and builders and masons to buy timber and hewn stone to repair the house. Howbeit there was no reckoning made with them of the money that was delivered into their hand, because they dealt faithfully. And Hilkiah the high priest said unto Shaphan the scribe, I have found the book of the law in the house of the Lord. And Hilkiah gave the book to Shaphan, and he read it. And Shaphan the scribe came to the king and brought the king word again and said, Thy servants have gathered the money that was found in the house, and have delivered it into the hand of them that do the work that have oversight of the house of the Lord. And Shaphan the scribe showed the king, saying, Hilkiah the priest has delivered me a book. And Shaphan read it before the king. And it came to pass, when the king heard the words of the book of the law, that he rent his clothes. And the king commanded Hilkiah the priest, and Ahikam the son of Shaphan, and Akbor the son of Micaiah, and Shaphan the scribe, and Ashahiah the servant of the king, saying, Go ye, inquire of the Lord of me, and for the people and all of Judah, concerning the words of the book that is found. For great is the wrath of the Lord that is kindled against them, because our fathers have not hearkened unto the words of the book. Do according unto all that is written concerning us. And so Hilkiah the priest, and Ahikam, and Akbor, and Shaphan, and Ashahiah went unto Huldah the prophetess, the wife of Shallum the son of Tikwa, the son of Harhas, keepers of the wardrobe. Now she dwelt in Jerusalem in the college, and they communed with her. And she said unto them, Thus saith the Lord God of Israel, Tell the man that sent you to me, Thus saith the Lord, Behold, I will bring evil upon this place, and upon the inhabitants thereof, even all the words of the book which the king of Judah has read, because they have forsaken me, and have burned incense unto other gods, that they might provoke me to anger with all the works of their hands. Therefore my wrath shall be kindled against this place, and shall not be quenched. But to the king of Judah, which sent you to inquire of the Lord, thus shall he say to him, Thus saith the Lord God of Israel, as touching the words which thou hast heard, because thy heart was tender, and thou hast humbled thyself before the Lord, when thou heard what I spake against this place and against the inhabitants thereof, that should become a desolation and a curse, and hast rent thy clothes, and wept before me, I also have heard thee, saith the Lord. Behold, therefore, I will gather thee unto thy fathers, thou shalt be gathered into thy grave in peace. And that I shall not see all the evil that I shall do unto the place. And they brought the king word again. And the king sent, and they gathered unto him all the elders of Judah and of Jerusalem. And the king went up into the house of the Lord, and all the men of Judah, and all the inhabitants of Jerusalem with him, and the priests and the prophets and all the people, both small and great, and he read in their ears all the words of the book of the covenant which was found in the house of the Lord. And the king stood by the pillar and made a covenant before the Lord to walk after the Lord, to keep his commandments and the testimonies and his statutes with all their heart and with all their soul, to perform the words of the covenant that is written in the book. And all the people stood to the covenant. And the king commanded Hilkiah the high priest, and the priests of the second order, and the keepers of the door, to bring forth out of the temple of the Lord all the vessels that were made for Baal, and for the crew, and for all the host of heaven. And he burned them without Jerusalem in the fields of Kidron, and carried the ashes unto them Bethel. And he put down the idolatrous priests whom the king of Judah had ordained to burn incense in the high places in the cities of Judah, and in places round about Jerusalem, them also that burned incense unto Baal, to the sun, to the moon, and to the planets, and to all the hosts of heaven. And he brought out the grove from the house of the Lord without Jerusalem unto the brook Kidron, burned it at the brook Kidron, stamped it into small powder, cast the powder thereof upon the graves of the children of the people. And he brake down the houses of the Sodomites that were by the house of the Lord, where the women wove hangings for the grove. And he brought all the priests of the cities of Judah that had defiled the high places, where the priests had burned incense, from Geba to Beersheba, and break down the high places of the gates that were in entering in the gate of Joshua, the governor of the city, which were on the man's left hand at the gate of the city. Nevertheless, the priests of the high places came not up to the altar of the Lord in Jerusalem, but they did eat of the unleavened bread among the brethren. And he defiled Tophet, which is in the valley of the children of Hinnom, that no man might make his son or his daughter to pass through the fire to Moloch. And he took away the horses that the king of Judah had given the son at entering the house of the Lord by the chamber of Nathan-Melech the chamberlain, and which was in the suburbs, and burned the chariots of the son with fire. And the altars that were at the top of the upper chamber of Ahaz, which the kings of Judah had made, and the altars which Manasseh had made in the two courts of the house of the Lord, did the king beat down and break them down from thence, and cast the dust of them into the brook of Kidron. And the high places that were before Jerusalem, which were set on the right hand of the Mount of Corruption, which Solomon the king had built it for Ashtaroth, the abomination of the Sidonians, and for Chemosh, the abomination of the Moabites, and for Milcom, the abomination of the children of Ammon, did the king defile. He brake in pieces the images, cut them to groves, filled the places with the bones of men. Moreover, the altar that was at Bethel and the high place, and Jeroboam the son of Nebat, who made Israel to sin, and burned the altar and the high place he brake down, burned the place, and stamped it into small powder, and burned the grove. And Joshua turned himself and spied the sepulchres that were in the mount, burned them to the altar, polluted it according to the word of the Lord, which the man of God had proclaimed, who proclaimed these words. Then he said, "What title is that that I see?" And the men of the city told him, "It is the sepulchre of the man of God which came from Judah, who proclaimed these things that thou hast done against the altar of Baal." And he said, "Let him alone, let no man move his bones." So they let his bones alone, with the bones of the prophet that came out of Samaria. And all the houses of the high places that were in the cities of Samaria, which the kings of Israel had made to provoke the Lord to anger, Joshua took away and did to them according to all the acts that he had done in Bethel. And he slew all the priests of the high places that were there upon the altars, and burned men's bones upon them, and returned to Jerusalem. And the king commanded all the people, saying, "Keep the Passover unto the Lord God, as it is written in the book of this covenant. Surely there has not holden such a Passover from the days of the judges that judged Israel, nor in all the days of the kings of Israel, nor of the kings of Judah, but in the 18th year of the king of Josiah, wherein this Passover was holden to the Lord in Jerusalem. Moreover, the workers with familiar spirits and wizards and images, idols and all the abominations were spied in the land of Judah and in Jerusalem, did Joshua put away, and he might perform the words of the law which were written in the book that Hilkiah the priest found in the house of the Lord. And like unto him, there was no king before him that turned to the Lord with all his heart and with all his soul and with all his might, according to the law of the book of Moses. Neither after him arose like there any like him. Notwithstanding, the Lord turned not from the fierceness of his great wrath, wherewith the anger was kindled against Judah, because all the provocations that Manasseh had provoked him withal. And the Lord said, "I will remove Judah also out of my sight, as I have removed Israel, and I will cast off the city, Jerusalem, which I have chosen, and the house which I said, my name shall be there." Now the rest of the acts of Josiah and all that he had, are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the kings of Judah? In his days, Pharaoh Necho, king of Egypt, went up against the king of Assyria to river Euphrates, and the king Josiah went against him, and he slew him at Megiddo, when he had slain him. And his servants carried him in a chariot dead from Megiddo, and brought him to Jerusalem, and buried him in his own sepulchre. And the people of the land took Jehoahaz the son of Josiah, anointed him, and made him king in the father's stead. Jehoahaz was 23 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 3 months in Jerusalem. And his mother's name was Hamutal, the daughter of Jeremiah out of Libna. And he did that was evil in the sight of the Lord, according to all that his fathers had done. And Pharaoh Necho put him in bands at Ribla, in the land of Hamath, that he might not reign in Jerusalem, and put the land to a tribute of 100 talents of silver and 1 talent of gold. And Pharaoh Necho made Eliakim, the son of Josiah, king in the room of Josiah his father, and turned his name to Jehoiakim, and took Jehoahaz away, and when he came to Egypt, he died there. And Jehoiakim gave the silver and the gold to Pharaoh But he taxed the land to give money according to the commandment of Pharaoh. He exacted the silver and gold of the people of the land, of everyone according to his taxation, to give to Pharaoh Necho. Jehoiakim was 25 years old when he began to reign. He reigned 11 years in Jerusalem. His mother's name was Zebudah, the daughter of Pedaiah of Roma. And he did that was evil in the sight of the Lord, according to all that his fathers had done. Chapter 24. In his days, Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came up, and Jehoiakim became his servant 3 years. Then he turned and rebelled against him. And the Lord sent him against the bands of Chaldees, the bands of Syrians, and the bands of the Moabites, and the bands of the children of Ammon, and sent them against Judah to destroy it according to the word of the Lord, which he spake by his servants the prophets. Surely at the commandment of the Lord came this upon Judah, to remove them out of sight, for the sins of Manasseh, according to all that he did, and also for innocent blood that he shed. For he filled Jerusalem with innocent blood that the Lord would not pardon. Now the rest of the acts of Jehoiakim in all that he did. Are they not written in the book of the Chronicles of the Kings of Judah? So Jehoiakim slept with his fathers, and Jehoiakim his son reigned in his stead. And the king of Egypt came not again any more out of his land, for the king of Babylon had taken from the river of Egypt unto the river Euphrates all that pertained to the king of Egypt. Jehoiakim was 18 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned in Jerusalem 3 months. And his mother's name was Nehushta, the daughter of Elnathan of Jerusalem. He did that was evil in the sight of the Lord, according to all that his father had done. At that time the servants of Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, came up against Jerusalem, and the city was besieged. And Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came up against the city, and his servants did besiege it. And Jehoiakim, the king of Judah, went out to the king of Babylon, he and his mother, his servants and his princes, and the officers. And the king of Babylon took him in the 8th year of his reign. And he carried out thence all the treasures of the house of the Lord, and the treasures of the king's house, and he cut in pieces all the vessels of gold which Solomon, king of Israel, had made in the temple of the Lord, as the Lord had said. And he carried away all Jerusalem, and all the princes, all the mighty men of valor, 10,000 captives, all the craftsmen and smiths, none remained, see the poorest sort of people of the land. And he carried away Jehoiakim to Babylon, the king's mother, the king's wife, his officers, the mighty of the land, those carried he away into captivity from Jerusalem to Babylon. And all the might of, and the king of Babylon made Mattaniah, his father's brother, king in his stead, and changed his name to Zedekiah. And Zedekiah was 21 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 11 years in Jerusalem. And his mother's name was Hakmuthal, daughter of Jeremiah of Libna. And he did that was evil in the sight of the Lord, according to all that Jehoiakim had done. For through the anger of the Lord it came to pass in Jerusalem and in Judah, until he had cast them out from his presence, that Zedekiah rebelled against the king of Babylon. Chapter 25 is the last chapter of the second book of Kings of the Old Testament of the Bible. Chapter 25. And it came to pass in the 9th year of his reign, in the 10th month, in the 10th day of the month, that Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came, he and all his host, against Jerusalem, and pitched against it, and they built forts against it round about. And that city was besieged unto the 11th year of King Zedekiah. And on the 9th day of the 4th month, a famine prevailed in the city, and there was no bread for the people of the land. And the city was broken up, and all the men of war fled by night by the way of the gate between the two walls, which is by the king's garden. Now the Chaldees were against the city round about, and the king went the way toward the plain. And the army of the Chaldees pursued after the king, overtook him in the plains of Jericho, and all the army were scattered from him. So they took the king, brought him up to the king of Babylon of Riblah. They gave judgment upon him, and they slew the sons of Zedekiah before his eyes, put out the eyes of Zedekiah, bound him with fetters of brass, carried him to Babylon. And in the 5th month, on the 7th day of the month, which is the 19th year, King Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, came. Nebuzaradan, captain of the guard, a servant of the king of Babylon, unto Jerusalem. And he burned the house of the Lord, the king's house, and all the houses of Jerusalem, and even great man's house he burned with fire. And all the army of the Chaldees that were with the captain of the guard break down the walls of Jerusalem round about. Now the rest of the people that were left in the city, and the fugitives that fell to the king of Babylon, with the remnant of the multitude that Nebuzaradan, the captain of the guard, carry away. But the captain of the guard left the poor of the land to be wine dressers and husbandmen. And the pillars of brass that were in the house of the Lord, and the bases and the brazen sea that was in the house of the Lord, did the Chaldeans break into pieces and carry the brass of them to Babylon. And the pots, the shovels, the snuffers, the spoons, all the vessels of brass wherewith they ministered, they took away. And the firepans and the bowls and such things that were of gold and silver in silver, the captain of the guard took away. The two pillars, one sea, and the bases which Solomon had made for the house of the Lord, the brass of all these vessels was without weight. The height of one pillar was 18 cubits, the chapiter upon it was brass, the height of the chapiter was 3 cubits, and the earthen work, the pomegranates upon the chapiter round about, all brass. And like unto these, a second pillar with the earthen work. And the captain of the guard took Sariah the chief priest, and Sephaniah the second priest, and the three keepers of the door. And out of the city he took an officer that was set over the men of war, and 5 men of them that were in the king's presence, which were found in the city, and the principal scribe of the host, which mustered the people of the land, and 80 men of the land that were found in the city. And Nebuzaradan, captain of the guard, took these and brought them to the king of Babylon, to Riblah. And the king of Babylon smote them, slew them at Riblah in the land of Hamath. So Judah was carried away out of their land. And as for the people that remained in the land of Judah, whom Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, had left, even over them he made Gedaliah, the son of Ahikam, son of Shaphan, ruler. And when the captains of the armies, they and their men, heard that the king of Babylon had made Gedaliah the governor, there came to Gedaliah to Mizpah even Ishmael the son of Nethaniah, and Johanan the son of Kariah, and Sariah the son of Tahumath the Netophathite, and Jesaniah the son of Makathite, and they and their men. And Gedaliah swore to them and to their men, and said unto them, fear not to be servants of Chaldees, dwell in the land, and serve the Lord, king of Babylon, and it shall be well with you. And it came to pass in the 7th month that Ishmael the son of Nethaniah, the son of Elishama, the seed royal, came, and 10 men with him, and smote Gedaliah, there he died, and the Jews and the Chaldeans that were with him at Mizpah, and all the people, both small and great, the captains of army, arose and came to Egypt, for they were afraid of the Chaldees. Came to pass in the 37th year of captivity of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, in the 12th month, on the 27th day of the month, that Evil-Merodach, king of Babylon, in the year that he began to reign, did lift up the head of Jehoiakim, king of Judah, out of the prison, and he spake kindly to him, set his throne above the throne of the kings that were with him in Babylon, and changed his prison garments. He did eat bread continually before him all the days of his life. And his allowance was a continual allowance given him of the king, a daily rate for every day, all the days of his life. Thus we end the book of the second book of Kings of the Old Testament. With this we come to the end of the whole book, the first book of Kings and the second book of Kings of the Old Testament of the Holy Bible.